The fund had another strong quarter in the September quarter, delivering over 11% returns for the period, which was almost double the MSCI index over the same period. From a bottom-up perspective, it's become increasingly clear that many large and important listed companies, particularly in the digital, climate, and healthcare sectors, are well placed to grow in a post-pandemic world. This has actually resulted in a bifurcated market since the March lows, with structural growth stocks outstripping companies that are worse off in a post-COVID world. The fund has benefited strongly from this trend, choosing to back businesses that are net better off because of COVID. And to date, we have not been tempted to bottom fish the so-called COVID losers until the path forward is clearer. From a stock attribution perspective, that meant most of our returns came from digital or semiconductor businesses or healthcare businesses, including TSMC in semiconductors, e-commerce in Amazon and Alibaba, and innovative health in Thermo Fisher and Danaher. Look, the fund maintained high net exposure through the quarter and is actually expected to maintain a reasonable high level of investment as we head into the coming quarters. Look, while we acknowledge the strong performance to date from the COVID lows and also the risks from the upcoming US election and another COVID spike over winter, we would flag that the equity risk premium available is still attractive. Interest rates are being held low, and this ultimately makes strong cash-generating growth companies still an attractive place to invest. We expect our investments in the areas of digital, e-commerce, innovative health, and climate to continue to deliver strong upcoming earnings results and also provide bullish outlook statements. And from a valuation perspective, we still see reasonable opportunities ahead in these areas. And in most cases, the stock moves that we've seen to date are simply reflecting a pull forward of market share gains. That said, we acknowledge that the outlook is still very uncertain. And as always, we remain prepared to use our capital preservation tools again, should they be required in the months ahead. Thanks for listening.